מישראל. I'm sixth generation here. I got married at 1988 with my husband. He lived in a kibbutz and we met at the Hatria party. And we decided we wanted to live here in the Samaria area. And we decided that this yishuv, the Nufim yishuv, will be our house. And we built it. And we live here almost 20 years. My two daughters were born here. The reason we came was because we wanted to build a settlement. I think it's a great honor for me as a Jew, as a Sabarit, that my grandmothers had built a settlement in a place in the north of Israel called Rosh Pina. For me, it's also a great honor to build also. So when we came here, there was nothing here. Only a very beautiful view, very nice weather, and stones. So from nothing, we built a community. From stones, now it's green, with all the facilities, the kindergarten, and for small babies, kindergarten, and the supermarket, and we have everything here. Very close to Tel Aviv, and very close to my parents in Kfar Saba. It's like 20 minutes. Most of the people here are working in Tel Aviv. The community is not religious, but nature of all the state of Israel, in every city, in every place, you have not religious people and religious people. But the this issue built for not religious people, but there are religious people here, and we have a synagogue, of course, like in every place. I'm not nervous, but I'm very angry about the government decision to freeze us. From 1967, after we freed the land, this part of the land, the Samaria and Judah, all the governments say all the time to people, go, live there, build houses there, build communities, build schools, live there. And I'm very angry now that they're doing what they do, because I think it's not a natural nature, and it's not normal to say to a citizen, to a good citizen, hello, hold your horses. I'm living here 20 years. I want my daughters to live near me. I want Be'ezrat Hashem to see grandchildren living around me, growing up, like all nature mother in the world want her children, in my case, my daughters, to be close, very near me. All mothers in the world have the right, yes, have the right to want their children and daughters to live next to them. Why don't I have this right? What did I do? I didn't do anything wrong. I am a good citizen. There is law in Israel. I didn't break the law, never. Why don't I have this natural right that have every mother in the world? We don't have problems around us with our neighbors, the Arabs. We are in a very good relationship with them. and there is one of them that have a big supermarket, and you can see every Friday a surrealistic picture that in the supermarket are coming to buy the Jewish people and the Arab people, and he has a coffee shop, and you can see every Friday Jewish people, soldiers, and the Arabs are sitting together at the coffee shop. Marvelous picture. We are not the answer to the solution of the world, the problems of the world. If Obama thinks that he will bother us and kick us out of the houses, and all these problems with Iran and Afghanistan and Iraq will be over, he's very naive, very, very naive, and mistake, of course. We are not the problem. I, as a Jew, believe, first of all, that this land gave us by God. If people does not believe me, they can go to read the Bible, the Jewish Bible. Everything is written there. Second of all, it's in a matter of security. Mr. Sharon made a move almost 5 years ago. He kicked out very good Jews from their houses and owned the land. Become a land of terrorists, and he thought it will be very silent after kicking the people out from Gush Katif, and all the world knows that after this all the south cities of Israel was bombed. If the government of Israel makes such a move, where I live will become a terrorist state. And for all people from Israel that living in Tel Aviv, Petah Tikva, downtown, they will be in a very not security life. What I want everybody to understand, that Israel is for the Jewish people, like England is for the British people, like France is for the French people, like the America is for the United States, is for the American people. And there is no American, even no one American citizen who would give the Liberty Statue for anything in the world. Why everybody thinks that I would give my only land for nothing and for anything and for something? This is my land. I don't have any other land. And leave me alone. Please leave us alone.